All right, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you guys are doing wonderful. So this topic is all about how to find the spirituality in Vedic astrology. Does Vedic astrology have a combination related to spirituality and spiritual progress? I would say why not? There are out of 9 planets, 2 planets constitutes for spirituality. Actually 3 planets. First is Saturn, second is Ketu, third is Mercury. Saturn, Ketu, Mercury, these three planets constitutes or signifies spirituality in your life. The more stronger are these three planets, the more you are inclined towards spirituality, even for that matter Sun as well. So total 4 planets. Alright, so most importantly, Ketu is considered as Karak for Moksha. He grants Moksha to the individuals. So all this kind of Brahma Jnanam, all the spirituality will be acquired. The planet that is signifying is basically Ketu. Alright, so if at all you have strong Ketu in your birth chart, let's say Ketu is in the 12th house, or Ketu is in the 9th house, or 8th house, 6th house, 3rd house, 1st house, all these, even the 5th house for that matter, these are all constitutes to spirituality in your life. You will be having that taste towards spirituality. You will be having that desire in terms of uplifting your spiritual levels, spiritual balances. Alright, so, and if you ask me about the house, okay, if at all you ask me about what is the, which is the house talks about spirituality, especially 12th house talks about spiritual progress. If at all you want to progress towards spiritually, you should be having the benefic planets like Jupiter, Venus, and Mars, and also Sun, Saturn, Rahu, even Ketu for that matter. It brings spirituality in your life. Alright, if at all you have Saturn plus Ketu combination in your birth chart, then you will be very disciplined in terms of spirituality. Nobody need to tell you that you will be doing your spiritual rituals without anybody telling it to you. Even you have Mercury and Ketu in the 1st house, 5th house, 9th house, 7th house and 11th house and 12th house, this also constitutes for spirituality in your life. The spiritual angle in your life can be seen from the combinations of Mercury and Ketu in your life. Alright, the stronger the Mercury is the planet of spirituality, Ketu is the planet of spirituality, these two planets should be stronger in your birth chart, so that there won't be any kind of obstacles in your spiritual journey. Okay, so in turn, in the horoscopes of great scholars like spiritual gurus and all that, they have stronger Ketu in their birth chart. That is the reason they will emerge as a spiritual leaders. If at all you have Ketu in the 6th house or 12th house, then you will be emerging as a spiritual leader. People will be following your advices. People will be respecting for the spiritual knowledge that you have. So all these things constitutes for spirituality. And also in the D9 chart, 1st house, 5th house, 7th house, 9th house, 11th house and 12th house talks about spirituality. Most importantly, 6th house and 12th house talks about spirituality. So the more stronger the planets in these houses, the more inclined towards your spiritual field. Okay, so this is just a short bite which I am just telecasting to you to make you to understand the spiritual angle in Vedic astrology. I have to actually see your birth chart to come into a conclusion whether how fast you can able to grow in spiritual journey can be seen from the 5th house, 9th house and 12th house. Alright, whether you can able to get siddhi of certain mantras also can be seen from the 5th house and 9th house. The more stronger the 5th house and 9th house, the more stronger will be the mantra siddhi in your life. Okay, all these things have to check from your birth chart. Each birth chart is unique in its nature. The planetary alignment in your birth chart is different from one another. It won't be same at all. If there are 1 million people in the world, let's consider there'll be 1 million combinations you can able to see from the astrology. That is the reason you can see that I'm making more and more videos, because you might not have all the combinations in your birth chart, but the combinations which the person having, he can able to learn from my videos, right? So that is all whole objective here. My objective is to ensure that you learn the astrology in a very easy way. So that is the reason I'm making all these videos, to make you to understand the knowledge of Vedic astrology. All right, I'm here to serve you. Please book for your astrology consultations. I'm happy to help you with the analysis, with the detailed analysis. and you won't be getting from any astrologer the kind of predictions I'll be giving it to you. That much detail my reports will be, and the way that I counsel to my clients is in very unique purpose. You can check my website. There you can find the recommendations under the detailed horoscope analysis. You can able to understand what I am doing to this world, what I am serving, in what manner I'm serving to this world. You can able to see from my website. All right, so please don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, because I'll be adding more and more videos. I need you guys support, and also do mention in the comment section what exactly you have learned from this video, so that I know that you are following my videos. Okay, click on that bell icon, click on that subscribe button, click on that bell icon, so that you will be notified about the future videos. All right, and that's it for today, guys, and have a spiritual journey ahead. And thank you so much for watching this video, and have a nice day. Bye for now.